After Chuck Stewart's story unraveled, we will hear from the family of Carol DiMaiti Stewart. This latest chapter in the Stewart story is unfolding at the office of attorney Marvin Geller, which is where we find News 7 reporter Victoria Black. Good morning, Victoria.
Good morning, R.D. We're live here in the office of the DiMaiti's family attorneys. We are told that Justo DiMaiti will read a statement on behalf of his family. He will not take any questions. His attorneys, we are told, will. Their combined statements are expected to run about 20 minutes. It has been a long, confusing, and painful 3 months for the DiMaitis. They have not talked with the press since their daughter died and since it was learned that her husband, Chuck Stewart, had a hand in her death. Hundreds of tearful family and friends said goodbye to Carol Stewart on October 28th, 5 days after she and her husband Chuck had been found shot in the Mission Hill section of Boston. At the time, he had told police a black man had shot them. Their families grieved for them and the loss of their prematurely born son, Christopher.
It's things like that happen to a lot of people, and you just never think it's going to happen to you, and it's reality right to the face, you know? And that's just the way it is.
But that's not the way it was. Shortly after he picked a suspect out of a lineup, Stewart's bizarre tale began to unravel. He became the suspect after his brother Matthew, reportedly driven by a guilty conscience, went to the police. Within hours of being told he was a suspect, he was dead. He jumped to his death from the Tobin Bridge, taking with him valuable pieces of a distorted puzzle. Carol Stewart's family was stunned.
Obviously, we're extremely sorry about what happened to my sister. Shocked by the charade that Chuck put up, and we really don't know what to think.
Meanwhile, Chuck Stewart's family held a news conference to say they were innocent after it was learned that several of Chuck's family members knew about his involvement and an insurance scam as early as 3 days after the murder, and that Matthew had been there the night of the killing. But Carol's aunt, Rosemary Leone, didn't buy it and told News 7's Jerry D'Amico they're guilty. Time magazine and Newsweek magazine ran cover stories about the hoax, and a grand jury was reconvened to hear evidence. Now Carol Stewart's family wants the truth. In a statement that Carl DiMaiti had made to the press a few weeks ago, he had said that he just wanted to know the truth. And when I spoke to Justo DiMaiti a few weeks ago as well, he had told me that of all the things that had been reported, no one had said what a wonderful daughter he had lost. And perhaps we will find out today whether or not there is some legal action that they will be taking. We are anticipating that the statement made by Mr. DiMaiti is going to be quite moving. R.D.?
Victoria, we understand there are a number of other attorneys representing different kinds of interests present at the news conference this morning. Do you have any sense of what they are going to be talking about materially?
We have not been told about the statements. We have no idea if they're going to announce any kind of legal action. We do know that John Wortman is the chief litigator here, and we also know that David Fassett, who will also be here with the DiMaiti family, is head of probate, and that indicates that there is some kind of a civil suit anyway in the wings.
Coincidence that this comes this morning as D.A. Newman Flanagan is quoted in the papers as saying that they had no hint that anyone other than the people they had been looking for and talking to, they had no idea that Chuck Stewart could have been involved in this.
I don't think that it is a coincidence. You know, a lot of politics is involved in what is going on here at this point. We anticipate that we will hear from the lawyers about the legal aspects, and we will hear from Mr. DiMaiti about the emotional aspect of this case, and we are hoping perhaps he will be able to clear up a few things for us. When I did talk with him a while ago, he had told me that the family was absolutely distraught, and he had been crying at the time on the phone, so we don't even know if he will be able to get through his statement. We hope that he will not be too taken aback by the sea of reporters here. This room is just absolutely packed full of people from all over the country that are interested in what they have to say. The DiMaiti family and the attorneys, as you can see, are just entering the room now. We will be hearing from Mr. Geller and Mr. John Wortman, as well as David Fassett, Carl DiMaiti. Evelyn DiMaiti is here as well, and Justo. They're all entering the room, and they will be reading statements. They are supposed to take about 20 minutes.
All right, thank you. Victoria Block, reporting live this morning from the office of attorney Marvin Geller. Members of the DiMaiti family and their attorneys meeting with the press this morning, announcing a number of things. One of them, the formation of a non-profit corporation, the Carol DiMaiti Stewart Foundation, being put together to dispense scholarship funds to worthy students, needy students in the Mission Hill section of Boston. We are out gathering other reaction to this latest chapter in the Stuart story that has unfolded this morning. We'll have more on the story on News 7 at noon and, of course, on our 5 and 6 o'clock reports. I'm R.D. Sahl, News 7. Now back to our regular program.
7 at 11. AT&T Premiere, The Incident, Sunday.
The designated driver plan only works if you plan ahead. Before you go out, decide who's going to drive and stick to the plan. The designated driver doesn't drink.
The footage that follows is not a recreation.
And they have a list of everybody and every card and every rate, and you can get that from them.
And that list of all the area banks and the credit cards with the rates, most people have one or two of them, you think?
And you have all of them.
Well,
you?
I didn't want to get into that necessarily, but
sitting here, I've got that.
Yeah.
She's got those rates covered.
No secrets here at News Center 5 at midday, folks. No, sir. Thank you very much, Celeste.
Well, I'm glad I was not a part of that conversation. As always, we thank you very much for being with us. Enjoy your afternoon.
Have a good day. Hope to see you tomorrow.
The 1989 legislative session rolled right into the 1990 session on January 3rd, and thousands of bills died, the victims of the legislature's unwillingness to vote them up or down. Bills which had been filed, printed, assigned to committee, researched, deliberated, amended, and partly even voted upon must start all over again. The House knows that's absurd. It supports a carryover rule. It's time for the Senate to go along. If it did, Massachusetts could keep legislation alive in the second year of the biennial session. It's a simple question of efficiency, something the Senate shouldn't be afraid of. Any bill that makes it through one branch shouldn't have to start all over again at the beginning of the second year of the session. 500 bills made it through one branch last year. Those include a bill to curb development, which is polluting our water supplies, and another which would improve air quality by further regulating auto emissions. They shouldn't have to go back to square one. The Senate should join the House in supporting a carryover rule. It will save time and money and earn the respect of the public in the bargain.
Service people face that angry public on the next Oprah Winfrey Show.
As long as winds will blow, my love.
You know, when they talk about processing some cereal, usually what they're talking about is taking something out, like the bran. Well, Instant Quaker Oatmeal takes nothing out, so you get all the oat bran nature ever intended. Instant Quaker Oatmeal. It's the right thing to do.
I owe you, Patricia, for bringing her back to us. I'll stop them any way I have to.
Hi, everyone. This is Eileen Prose. A kinder, gentler Geraldo for the 90s. The controversial talk show host is changing his image, and on our next Good Day, he'll be my co-host. We'll talk to him about the show's new look. Join us, won't you? Good day tomorrow at 9.
At girls' clubs, a girl learns that it doesn't matter where she comes from as long as she knows where she's going.
When I grow up, I want to be a doctor.
Service people face that angry public on the next Oprah Winfrey Show.